Massive shout out to Blazing Boost. The reason why I recommend their service is that they are strong and stable. Their Trustpilot reviews keep growing and are almost at 17k now with a 5 out of 5 score, and they are rated excellent on Trustpilot. The new season is here and I strongly recommend all of their Sherpa services. They are completely safe and save you a lot of time, allowing you to also learn and have fun. I recommend checking their Sherpa trial services for this weekend because obviously trials will be quite hard. However, if you guys are looking to play with the pros, they also offer a pro service right now. And obviously, if you're struggling with anything Destiny 2 related, make sure to check out Blazing Boost using the links in the description. And let's jump straight into today's video. Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. Today, I'm going to be showing you how to get high stat armor in the brand new update. So if you guys are new, remember to subscribe, drop a like on today's video. Let's try and get 100 likes on this high stat armor. Now let me know what your favorite thing is about the brand new season, and with that said, let's jump straight into it. So pretty much this is one of the easiest ways you guys can actually do this, and obviously it's one that is a little bit hidden and not that many people know about it. So all you're gonna want to do is fast travel to the tower, and then once you are here, I'm going to be showing you exactly how you can get really good high stat armor. Now this armor is going to be made for builds, that sort of thing. So if you guys are new to the game, which I know a lot of you are, obviously you have a total stat armor, that sort of thing, and you have different sections. So you have intellect, which obviously does different things. So we're basically going for high stat rolls in certain categories. Now sometimes these stats aren't a total high, however in some cases a certain attribute like intellect or something like that will be really high. So the really easy way to do this with the brand new season is to go to obviously the vendors in the tower. Now as you can see, total stats wise it's not the best armor, but obviously you do get the occasional piece like here where it does have a high intellect like 21, and I've even seen 27s and 30 pluses with this week. So every single week this vendor will change, and obviously it's different on every single character. So for this week, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you them on every single character, and hopefully you guys will get some good armor. So for the hunter, the ones that I'd recommend to get is obviously the helmet with that high intellect. Everything else isn't really worth getting, but trust me, I would get that helmet if you haven't got it already. Now the next vendor that will be selling high stat gear is also Shax, which is a Crucible vendor. So if you head on over to him and look around, as you can see, mobility 21, discipline, intellect, that's a really good one to get, so I'd definitely get that one. This one here as well, high recovery build 20, that's good. Oh, with discipline and intellect and recovery is a really good build. So for the hunter, it's pretty good. The rest of them I wouldn't really bother with, but definitely get the chest piece and the arms if you guys haven't already. Then what you're going to want to do is simply fast travel over to the Annex and then go to the Gambit vendor. Now these are the three in the tower. I believe these are the only ones that do have decent gear. If you've discovered any others, let me know down in the comment section below so that I can make a future upload on it. But if we go over to the Gambit man, let's see what he's got for the hunter. So for the hunter, gauntlets I wouldn't bother, chest armor 17 I wouldn't bother with that. Here we are guys, look at that, helmet 26, discipline. So if you're going for a discipline build, I'm gonna actually pick that up myself, definitely get that one. That's probably the best one of the week for the hunter. And then the leg armor I wouldn't really bother with, but there's a few good pieces out there for the hunter. So what I'm gonna do quickly is I'm gonna swap characters so you guys don't have to check it, and obviously I'll show you what is on the Titan and Warlock. So let's quickly swap characters and head on over to the tower. Alright guys, so we are on the Warlock. Let's head on over to Zavala and see what he's selling this week. Hopefully something good. For the Hunter, it is a pretty good week as well. Now if you want me to do this every single week, let me know down in the comment section. Just saves you guys' time on what pieces to actually go and get. So arms, discipline, not the best. It's not bad. Obviously if you're new to the game, definitely pick it up. Chest piece, not so good. Legs, I wouldn't bother. And leg armor, not so good. So I wouldn't really go for any of them unless you really need to. Now, obviously, it does reset every single week, so make sure you guys do check. And obviously, it's different on every single character. Let's do this. Arms, recovery 18, not the best. Chest, not the best again. You're looking for anything above 20 really if you guys can. And yet again, nothing on the Warlock from the Crucible. Let's go to the Gambit. Usually Gambit has something good for the Warlock, but we'll see. All right, let's see. Come on, Drifter. You should have something good, hopefully. If you are a main Warlock and this guy doesn't have anything good, I can only apologize. Gauntlets aren't too bad. Strength, mobility. Chest armor, shit. There we go. That's a really good one. Helmet again for the Warlock. 26 strength and 16 resilience. Really good strength build. So definitely pick that up. To be fair, that's probably the only piece you want to pick up on your Warlock this week. I'll definitely be doing that when I can. So that is the only piece, and it does actually have a total of 60. So 60 stats as well, guys, are really good to get. I did forget to mention that. But yeah, 60 as well. That is definitely the best piece we've seen this week. So make sure you do pick that up. Now I'm going to quickly swap over to my Titan, and then hopefully we'll see what he's selling over there. Hopefully it's a bit better than the Warlock. Right, final character. We are on the Titan. Hopefully it's got something decent. Now, I do really appreciate the support on the channel. We are going for that 40k milestone. So if you could help towards that, I would really appreciate it. So let's see. Arms, wouldn't bother picking them up this week. Then we do have the chest armor. Not so good again. Helmet, nothing from that. And then leg armor, nothing again. So Zavala for the Warlock and the Titan, not so good. But let's head on over to Shax. Arms, not so good. I mean, chest armor is not bad, 19 resilience, but it's not the best. Then we do have this right here. Now it's a pretty well-rounded build sort of piece. Obviously you've got mobility, recovery and discipline, so it's not a bad piece to pick up. Definitely one, if you've got an average build, pick it up just in case. And then leg armor is completely shit, so don't bother with that. And then the final vendor of the video for the Titan is gonna be the Drifter. Now he had something good for the Warlock and the Hunter. Probably the best pieces this week are at Drifter. So let's see if it's the same with the Titan. Right, what have we got then? Arms, wouldn't recommend picking them up. Chest armor, not so good. Helmets, pretty crap as well. And this one right here is not bad. Intellect plus 20 with a resilience of 17. I'd pick that up from the Drifter. The boots are pretty good. But that is all the vendors done for every single character. I thought I'd share with that information, obviously, because I know a lot of armor pieces do want to get changed and you are trying to get the best builds. Now, I am going to make the best PvE builds and the best PvP builds, which I do every single season. But like I said, let's try and hit 100 likes and hopefully I'll get some of them out to you as soon as I can. And as always, guys, I hope you did enjoy. Leave a like, subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one.